Hi all, welcome back to Computer Organization course. We'll get started.
Next, we will see about the different types of instructions like 3-address, 2-address and 1-address. First, we'll discuss about the 3-address instructions. Now, say for example, you want to add the contents of the location A and B and you have to move the result to C, the memory location. We can accomplish this by a single machine instruction. So how can we do that? So this is an example for that. Okay, add A comma B comma C. This is a single machine instruction which adds the contents of the location A and B and it would store the result in C. This is a 3-address instruction. Okay, now here A and B are called as source operands and C is called the destination operand. This is the basic structure. First is the operation, then you have source 1, source 2 and destination. Here operation is add, source 1 is A, source 2 is B and destination is C. The contents of A and B are added and the result is placed in C. This is 3-address instruction. Next we will see 2-address instruction. Now, say suppose you want to add same. You want to perform the operation C is equal to A plus B. How do we do it in a 2-address instruction? First what happens is, first we will see the syntax, okay? The first one is operation, next we have source and destination. Now what happens here is, first if we write like this, add A comma B. Now this says add the content of A to the content of B and store the result in B itself. Okay, here it says when the sum is calculated, the result is sent to the memory and stored in the location B, replacing the original content of this location. Here B will act as both source as well as destination. Now, if you consider another instruction such as move B, C. Now, what does it do? This move means load or fetch the contents of the B and load it into C. Finally, what have you achieved? You have added A plus B and you have moved the contents of the sum to C. You have achieved this one. C is equal to A plus B. Okay, how can we write that? Like add A comma B, then move B comma C. Okay, now move B comma C, then we have add A comma C. What does it do this? Now the contents of the location B are moved to C, then the contents of the location C is added with A and the result is again stored in C itself. Getting it? Next, we will see about the 1-address instructions. Now, we have already seen 2-address and 3-address instructions, right? Now, even the 2-address instructions will not normally fit into one word for the word length and address size. So, the another possibility is to have only one memory operand. Now, the processor register, usually called as an accumulator, will be used for this purpose. 1-address instruction looks something like this, add A. Now, what it does is, the contents of the A will be added to the accumulator register and the sum would be placed in the accumulator itself. Again, you have load A instruction. What it does, it loads the contents of the memory location A to the accumulator register. Store A, what will it do? So, it writes the content of the A to the accumulator. Getting it? Next, we will study about instruction execution and straight line sequencing. How the instruction will be executed, that is how it is, the instruction is fetched from the memory, how it is executed and how it is stored back, and what is straight line sequencing. Say suppose consider you want to perform this operation. C is equal to A plus B. Now, consider this as our memory and we have the variables memory locations here A, B and C. Okay, now we have this program, that is a 3-instruction program segment. It says move A comma R naught. That means the contents of location A are moved to R naught. Then add B comma R naught. That means content of B will be added to content of R naught. Now what are the content of R naught? It is nothing but the content of A. So you have B and A added together. Now the result will be placed in R0 and this in the third instruction, the result would be moved to the memory location C. Finally, what you have achieved? You have achieved C is equal to A plus B. Okay, now you got it right. So these are the memory locations A, B, and C where your data is present. Say suppose A is 5, B is 10. Okay, and say suppose C previously it had some value, say 17. Okay, so this is our content. Now we will assume that this is a 32 bit word length. Okay, the word length here is 32 bits. The n is 32 bits. Okay, now what happens is if you consider this as 32 bits and memory is byte addressable. Okay, now you know our program would start from the location I. It is given here, begin execution here, that is I. Our program will start from the location I. As this is 32 bit word length and it is byte addressable, so 4 bytes would be present here. First, the memory location would start from I. Next, it would be plus 4, that is I plus 4th location. The next address would be present in I plus 8. The next instruction would be present in I plus 12, like this. Now let's consider how the program is executed. Now this C is equal to A plus B, this instruction, how it is executed, we'll see. Okay. Do you guys remember the program counter which we discussed in the first chapter? What it does, it holds the address of the instruction to be executed next. Say suppose, consider, okay, this is I, right? So here there is some program. So PC was incremented, and now right now PC points here to the ith location. What happens now is the address of the first instruction, that is I in our case, it is there in the PC, that is program counter. Then the process control circuits use the information from the PC, that is program counter, to fetch and execute instruction one at a time. Now in order of increasing address, this is called as straight line sequencing. This means first the PC would point here to the ith location. It would, this instruction move A comma R naught would be executed. While it is executing, the PC would be pointed to the next instruction. Then the second instruction would be executed. When this is getting executed, PC would be again pointing to the next instruction. Again, this process continues. This happens step by step, right, in a sequence. That's why it is called as straight line sequencing. Now, during the execution of each instruction, as we all know, the PC will be incremented by 4 to point to the next instruction. Why the program counter is incremented by 4? That is because the word length is 32 here. That means 4 bytes. That's why it would be incremented by 4. Okay. Now, executing a particular instruction, it is a two-phase procedure. Now, suppose if we consider this instruction move A, R0, just for executing this instruction, we have two phases. The first phase is called as instruction fetch. In this instruction fetch, what happens is the instruction is fetched from the memory location whose address is in the PC. Now, this instruction is placed in the IR in the processor. We know this one, right? Instruction fetch phase. The instruction move A, R0 would be fetched from the memory. How it is fetched? The PC would be pointing to the current location I. Then the address is transferred to MAR. Then a read signal is initiated. After some time lapse, what happens? The instruction is read from the memory. It will be moved to MDR and from MDR to IR. This we have discussed in the first chapter, if you remember, right? This is the instruction fetch cycle. Next, the second phase, we call it as instruction execute. Now you have the instruction move A, R0 in the instruction register. What is the next step? It has to be executed, right? The instruction in the IR is examined to determine which operation is to be performed. The specified operation is then performed by the processor. Now what happens? Suppose move A, R0, your IR, it understands that this is a move operation. Suppose it was add there, then addition would be performed. Then if you have subtraction, that would be performed, right? Something like this. Now, once the operation is performed, the result would be stored back to either the memory or to the processor register. At some point during this two-phase execution procedure, right, the content of the PC are incremented to point to the next instruction. So when the execute phase of an instruction is completed, the PC will contain the address of the next instruction, and again new instruction fetch phase can begin. Getting it? Next we will, okay, these two slides explain the same thing. Okay, these two slides will explain the procedure for this straight line sequencing. Next we will study about branching. Consider the task of adding a list of n numbers. Say suppose you want to add 50 numbers. So how do you write a program? If we go by straight line sequencing, you will write something like this. What you do? First you will move the number 1 to a register. Make sure that this number 1, number 2, number 3, this sum, these are all the, are the memory location which hold some data. Okay. Now, num1, suppose it is 1. Num2, again it is, say suppose 1. Likewise, you have 50 numbers. Say suppose the 50th number which is say 21. Now what you have to do is you have to add these all things. That means 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus like something like this till 21. So how do you write a program for that? So you would write something like this. First, move the number 1, that is the value content 1, to a register R0. Then add number 2 to that R0. Next, add number 3 to R0. Likewise, you have to add till 50th number. Then what you have to do? You have to move the result to a variable called sum here. Now what happens in this case is, as and when you are adding a long list of numbers, if you take straight line sequencing, it would be too long program. Okay, it is a memory wastage. So to overcome this problem, what we can use is, we can use a loop or branching. Now let us study about that. So this is a program, same program of adding n numbers using a loop. Instead of straight line sequencing, we are here using a loop. Okay, now what happens here is, say suppose you want to add 5 numbers. Okay, so say suppose you want to add 5 numbers, this memory location n, it says the number, how many numbers you want to add, that is 5. This n contains a value called 5, that means 5 numbers have to be added. Suppose the number 1 value is 1, number 2 value is 2, number 3 value is again 1, number 4 value is, say suppose, 4, and number 5 value is 10. Okay, so your number 1 is 1, the data is 1. Now what you have to do, you have to add 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 4 plus 10. Now you have to add these 5 numbers and you have to place the sum in this particular variable. Now how do you write a program? I don't want to use a straight line sequencing because it will be too lengthy. So we can write something like this. Now we'll see the execution of this particular program. First, what we'll do is we'll move the content of n, okay, to a register called R1. Now what is the content of n? So n is nothing but, it says how many numbers you want to add. So the content of n is here 5. Okay, so what it is doing here, it is moving the content of n to a register R1. So first what happens, R1 is equal to 5. Is this correct? Right. Okay, now this R1 will act as a counter here. Okay, so each time a number is added, this would be decremented here. Fine, we'll see that later. So basically, first what we are doing, we are moving the content of n to a register called n1. So the content of n is 5, so that get moves to R1. Now we will have another register called R0 and we will clear it. So if there is any existing content present in R0, let us just remove that. Okay, so R0 is equal to, say, 0. We have cleared it. Okay, this is R0. Okay, next what we are doing here is our program loop. Now how does this program loop work? Now this says determine the address of the next number and add the next number to R0. Now what is the first number? Our first number is num1. So it says determine address of the next number. Okay, the next number here is number 1. The PC will point to here and it takes the content of this particular location, num1, okay, and it has to be added to content of R0. So now num1 plus R0, so what would be the content of R0 here? It would be, previously R0 was 0, we had cleared it, then you have to add num1 to this R0. 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. The new value of R0 is now 1. Now what you have to do is, you have to decrement R1. What is the content of R1? It is 5. You have to decrement it. Decrement means minus 1. So R1, so what happens? This 5 minus 1. So your R1 content is now 4. Okay. Now you have a branch condition here. Now what does it say? The branch is greater than 0, then loop. That means this R1, branch is here nothing but R1. Check if R1 is greater than 0. What is your content of R1? It is 4. Is 4 greater than 0? Yes. Now what it has to do? Whenever this condition is true, it has to go back to this location, loop. Where is this location loop? It is here. Instead of going to the next instruction, your PC should be moved back to this location. So that depends on this branch condition. Getting it? So I'll explain once again. So whenever you decrement the content of R1, okay, that content of the R1 is checked with this condition. That is R1 greater than 0. In our first case, R1 is 4. So 4 is greater than 0. That's why whenever it is true, it has to go back. Your PC should again point to this loop location, and loop is here. Now, what does this loop say? It says determine the address of the next number and add next number to R0. So basically in the first iteration, we have added num1, that is 1, to our R0, right? Now again it says determine the address of the next number. So which is the next number? It is num2. Now it says we have already determined the address of this number, right? Now add this 2 to the register R0. So basically now what we have to do in the second iteration. So your R0, okay, previously it was 1. Now the content has to be added with the next number, that is this one, 2. Okay. Now 1 plus 2 is 3. Fine. Now this is done. Next, what you have to do? You have to decrement R1. What is the value of R1? In the previous iteration, it was 4. Decrement it. Decrement means minus 1. So what happens? This 4, R1 was in the previous iteration was 4. So 4 minus 1. Now it is 3. Right? Now you have to check again. The next instruction. Branch greater than 0 loop. Check if R1 is greater than 0. What is our content of R1? It is 3. Is 3 greater than 0? Yes. What do you have to do now? You have to go back to this loop again. Now, again, you have to perform this task. Let us do that. Okay. Now, again, determine the address of the next number and add it to the content of R0. Now, what is the content of R0 here? Previously, it was 3. Now, in the next iteration, the third iteration, what happens? R0, the previous content was 3. Now, it has to be added with num 3. Okay, it is not written here. Okay, now 1 has to be added to this one. Fine. Now the new content of R0 is 4. Next, decrement R1. Okay, so what was R1? It was 3, right? So decrement it. 3 minus 1, that is 2. Fine. Again, check if 2 is greater than 0, loop, right? Again, go back to the loop, add again the content of R0 with the next number. So R0 content was previously 4. Now add that with the next number. What is the next number? Num4? It is 4. Okay. 4 plus 4, it is 8. Now what will be the content of R1? You have to decrement it, right? This instruction has to be executed. So decrement R1. Previously it was 2. So what is the new value now? 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. Now check if 1 is greater than 0. Is 1 greater than 0? True. Yes. You have what you have to do? You have to go back to this loop again. Now, what happens in this loop? Again, R0 value would be calculated. What was the previous value here? It was 8. 8 will be added with what? The next number. What is the next number? It is 10. So 8 would be added with 10. Your result is 18. Now decrement R1. So what is the value of R1 in the last iteration? It was 1. So 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. Right? Now check. Is 0 greater than 0? Okay. Check if R1 greater than 0. What is the latest content of R1? It is 0. Is 0 greater than 0? No. It is false. Then will the control go over here to the loop? No. Only if this condition is true, you have to execute this loop. If it is false, your PC has to be moved here and you have to execute the next instruction, that is this instruction. So in our case, the latest value of R1 is 0. So this condition R1 greater than 0 becomes false and the next condition would be executed. What is the next condition? You have to move the content of R0 to sum. What is the content of R0 now? It is 18. Where you have to move this 18? To the location sum, that is here. Okay. Now, this is how a branching works. Getting it? We will have a quiz now. So, you have to say the statement is right or wrong. Okay. The instruction add A, B, C. This explains the contents of the memory location B and the contents of the memory location C are added and the result or the sum is stored in A. Is this explanation about this instruction is right or wrong? You have to say right or wrong. Okay. Your time starts now. Okay, time's up. Next, we'll see the practice questions. You know how to write the answers and all, right? So, just write the question and answers. Again, same procedure. Take the pic, do the PDF. I'll tell you when to upload and where to upload. Okay? That's it for today. We'll conclude our session. Thank you.